If p is less than or equal to 0.05, the test is significant, which in this case means the sample is significantly different than a mu of 4, or a neutral response. If p is greater than 0.05, the test is not significant, meaning the sample is not significantly different than a mu of 4, or mean of 4. So here we see our p-value of 0.379. And because, well, first of all, you should ask yourself, okay, which of these two conditions applies? Which does it fall into? And we can see here that 0.379 is, in fact, greater than 0.05. So we're going to conclude that the test is not significant, which means that the sample is not significantly different than the mean of 4. The responses for those 30 people, the mean response did not significantly differ from a 4. And we could write our results in APA format using the format of the American Psychological Association. And we could say something like the following. People who were surveyed had neither a significantly favorable or unfavorable perception of the politician. So in other words, they weren't any different from neutral. And then we have a T, which is telling the reader that we used a T-test, in this case a one-sample T, with 29 degrees of freedom, which you can see reported right here, and that's equal to N minus 1, so 30 minus 1 is 29. Our T-value that was calculated in SPSS was equal to 0.89, which you can see right here. We rounded it to two decimal places. And then next we report the p-value, which we already discussed right here. Okay, now the p-value, it is optional if you want to, or if you're taking a class and your instructor would like you to report p is greater than 0.05 instead of the exact p-value, you can do that. Although reporting the exact p-value is more informative, and therefore it really is recommended. Hey, one last thing before we close here. Notice this confidence interval. We talked about this in the previous video on the one-sample t-test. And if you recall from that video, we had said that if the confidence interval includes zero, if the confidence interval, in particular, the 95% confidence interval, if it includes the value of zero, that means the test is not statistically significant. And notice this does include zero. Zero falls in between these values. And the test here was not significant. So these two outcomes will always agree. Had this not included zero, like for example, say this ranged from 0.26 to 0.76, well then this would have been less than 0.05. Okay, so they will always be in agreement. So we really could just look at our confidence interval to determine whether or not the test is statistically significant. This concludes the presentation on the one-sample t-test in SPSS. Thanks for watching.